Now that you know the basic steps for logging data with the Kvaser Memorator Professional, we can discuss methods for reducing the extraneous data recorded so you can focus on the information that is important. The Memorator tools provides two methods for controlling the data recorded, filters and triggers. In order to create a filter or trigger based on a message, you must first define a message. To define a message local to the configuration, use the Define Messages section of the Memorator tools. Add a new message by pressing the Add Message button. Enter a name and DLC. If you're entering the full identifier, please leave the protocol set to None. If you're going to just enter the parameter group number in the identifier field, set the protocol to J1939. If you would like to enter the identifier in hexadecimal, place a dollar sign or 0x in front of the number. Check the extended identifier checkbox if you're using a 29-bit identifiers instead of 11. Press OK to complete the message entry. Now we can define signals within the message by selecting the message and pressing the Add Signal button. Enter the name of the signal, byte order, sign state, start bit, bit length, scale, and offset. Then press OK to complete entering the signal information. To use a group of message definitions across multiple configurations, use the provided database editor to create a DBC file containing the message definitions. You can then associate the DBC file with the configuration in the database section. Press the Add button and browse for the desired DBC file. You can also set which channels the DBC file is associated with. Having defined your messages, you can reduce the data recorded to only the messages you're interested in by using filters. Press the Add button to create a new filter. Check the channel checkboxes for the canned channels you would like this filter to be applied to and press the Next button. If you use J1939 mode to define the message, select J1939 mode. Otherwise, select None and press the Next button. You now need to decide what type of filter you want to create. You have three options. A canned message filter is a filter based on the message identifier. A canned signal filter is a filter based on the value of a signal within the specified message. And finally, a type of message filter is a filter based on the type of canned frame. Press the Select button beside the type of filter you would like to create. If you choose a canned message filter, you will be prompted to select the specific message from the messages associated with the configuration through the Define Messages section and Database section. If you choose a canned signal filter, you'll be prompted to select the specific channel and enter a raw value to be watched for. You can use the Calculate button to enter the value in physical units. If you chose a type filter, you will be prompted to select error frames, standard identifiers, or extended identifiers. When you press the Next button, you'll be prompted to choose how the filter is to be applied. You can choose a stop filter to block any messages that meet the filter from being recorded and allow the remaining messages to be recorded. Or you can choose a pass filter to allow messages that meet the filter to be recorded while blocking the remaining messages. The final option is a counting pass filter, which works like a pass filter, but only records the matching messages every nth time the message is seen. You'll be prompted to enter the number of times to record and the number of times seen for this filter. Triggers are used to control when data is logged. The first step when creating a trigger is to make sure the Log Everything checkbox in the Log Configuration section is not checked. To create a trigger, press the Add button in the Trigger section. You'll be prompted to name the trigger and which canned channel the trigger is to monitor. If the trigger is based on a message defined using J1939 protocol, set the protocol to J1939. Otherwise, set the protocol to None. Press the Next button and you'll be prompted to select the type of trigger. If you select a canned message trigger, you will be prompted to select the defined message whose reception will cause the trigger condition to be met. If you select a signal trigger, you will be prompted to select the signal whose value will be evaluated by the trigger. When you press the Next button, you'll be prompted to enter the raw value to compare the signal value against the type of comparison to be used, less than, equal to, greater than, etc. If you select an external trigger, you'll be prompted for whether the trigger should occur on the rising or falling edge of the external trigger. If a special event trigger is selected, you'll be prompted to choose either power on event, disk full event, or error frame received event as the triggering condition. If you choose the timer event trigger, you will be prompted to enter the number of seconds after power on when the timer event should fire. You can also choose to make the timer event periodic by checking the cyclic checkbox. After you've selected the correct trigger type and pressed the next button, you will be prompted for the trigger timeout. This is the length of time that the trigger condition is considered true once the trigger is detected. This value is useful when you have multiple triggers that must occur at the same time to start logging. Once you've entered the desired value and pressed next, you'll be provided with a summary screen of the trigger configuration. Press finish to create the trigger. Once you've created the trigger, you must establish the pre-trigger time, trigger expressions, and post-trigger time. The pre-trigger time determines how much data should be recorded prior to the trigger expression that starts the logging is met. The post-trigger time determines how long data should be recorded after the trigger expression is met. If the post-trigger time is set to 0, logging will only stop when a stop logging trigger expression is met. The trigger expressions are created by entering the desired trigger names in the expression field. You can use AND to AND two trigger conditions and vertical bar to OR two trigger conditions. You can also use parentheses to control the order of operation within the expression. For example, this would read as if trigger 1 or trigger 2 is true and trigger 3 is true, then the expression is true. A trigger expression can be set to start logging, stop logging, start logging impulse, stop logging impulse, stop logging completely, or just pulse. Pulse means to pulse the external contact output on the CAN channel 2 connector. Stop logging completely means that the unit will not evaluate the trigger conditions again. The unit will need to be powered off and back on before the unit will log data again. After configuring your triggers and filters, you should remember to use the target check configuration menu item to make sure that the triggers and expressions can be translated by the Memorator tools into a proper configuration. For more information about triggers, please see the Kvaser Memorator Professional Setup Tool Trigger Guide that is installed with the Memorator Tools package.